What's going on, everybody? It's Mr. Do It On. I'm bringing you back another MLB The Show 17 Road to the Show gameplay here. You see here, we're taking on the Minnesota Twins. And it's the top of the first. It looks like I am the leadoff hitter today. 0-0 game, 1-1 count. Here we go. So let's go ahead and take a fastball right down the cock and doodles. So let's go ahead and talk a little bit about the MLB overall standings and stuff. See right there, we get a nice piece, nice little base hit right there. And who potentially could be the favorites? Wow, we're actually going to get a single with a taking second base on the error by the left fielder. So way to go, left fielder. Here's the problem I do have with the show is you see right there, it's a 3-0 count. And the pitcher on the mound has thrown about, oh Jesus, I think we're definitely going to get caught stealing. That was a great jump. He just quick pitched. Is the fact that it was a 3-0 count, he's only thrown 4 pitches apparently, and I probably saw about 3 or 4 pitches in my bat. I don't understand how that happens, why that happens. It makes no sense to me. But yeah, going back to the topic at hand, the state of the MLB standings, you see right there, we swing at strike one, and we're going to take ball two, ball one, the slider down. This guy's first pitch is a slider, so that's something that I do not like that much in the show either. It's a little early on the fastball, is guys who have a first pitch that's not a fastball. So as you see right here, I clearly right now believe right there, we're going to pop out to the catcher, which we do a lot of. Just fucking bullshit. I do clearly believe that the Dodgers are the best team in the majors right now. And in a very, very close second is the Astros. Now, I would love to see... I'd be totally zoomed in to a Dodgers-Astros World Series because you have the underdog Astros going up against... There's a little foul ball there. Going up against a powerhouse like the Dodgers now. In MLB, you don't see powerhouses like you used to. But this team is so... The Dodgers are so great top to bottom with young talent. And they have guys like Kershaw at the top of the rotation who are also not only the best players at their position, but they're also... They're not young, but they're not old. They're still at the top of their game. And you have the Astros who... The last couple of years have been, I guess you can say, the Rangers' bitch in the West. So right there, we get a walk after being down 0-2, so that's a good at-bat. It's a great at-bat for us. But yeah, I mean, every other division isn't as strong as I would think it would be. The NL West is probably the best division in all of baseball right now. I mean, you have 3 teams that have over 45 wins. Not another division can say that. In the AL, probably the best division is the AL East. But that division could be a lot better than what it is here that we're gonna go first to home, it looks like, yeah. And we're second to home actually. So let's take a little run score for us. We're 62 here. I mean, you have the Yankees at 41-33, the Red Sox at 42-34. The Rays somehow are 40-38. The Orioles are a game below 500, and the Blue Jays are 36-39. That division is they're off 5.5 games of each other, from top to bottom, which is a I don't know if that's saying that it's a good division or it's just saying that there's a nice little base hit to the right side, and we're gonna take second on this throw, and we're in there. So that's a little risk, but, you know, you gotta take those risks sometimes. The AL Central, pretty average. The Indians are only 5 games above 500 in first place. I don't think anybody thought the Twins were gonna, you know, sustain their overall start, you know. See right there, we scored, and we're 2-for-3 in this game. 2 singles, we have a 10-4 lead. But I've seen crazy shit happen in this game where, you see right there, get another base guess. Yeah, so that makes it 3-for-4. But yeah, I mean, see, look at that. The Twins are so bad defensively in this game that I'm surprised this was in an error, too. That we took second base. So that was pretty nice. Puts us in scoring position. And you see here the it. Are we still in? It looks like that ball is going to get out. So we're scoring again. That's like 2 or 3 runs scored in this game. We're going to end up winning this game. Carlos Gomez is the MVP of the game for his one home run. And you see here, we're traveling to Oakland, to Baltimore. And we're leading off again. We're getting we're guessing fastball up here. And it looks like we're just a little late. I mean, contact was always good, I guess. Whatever, show. And you have the AL West here. The Astros are 12.5 up on the second place Angels. They actually beat the Dodgers yesterday to snap their 10-game win streak. But they're doing this without Trout, too, so that's pretty impressive. I mean, right now, the Angels would be the second wildcard team if the season ended today. Mariners are right there at 39-39. Rangers are 38-38. And A's are 34-42. I mean, those bottom teams, let's see if they're going to need a double. Those bottom teams after the Angels are all right there within striking distance to make a wildcard berth, I guess you can say. I mean, the Astros are 52-25. They're over 25 games above 500. 7-3 in their last 10. I mean, look at that. How are you going to bunt that, like, with two outs? Like, what are you doing? Like, why would you bunt that? You don't have that type of speed like that, man. Anyways, and then we're going to go to the NL now. So we're going to start in the East. The Nationals are 8.5 up on the Braves right now. NL East is bad. That might be one of the worst divisions in baseball. That might be the second worst division in baseball, I guess. And the Nationals, if the Nationals don't win this division, that's a damn shame. And the Braves are 36-39, 8.5 out. The Marlins are 34-40, 10 games out. I mean, I just don't understand. Like, I mean, yeah, maybe, I don't know. The Nationals should run away. You have the Mets over here at 34-41. Swinging at a ball there, fouling it off, and now it's 1-2 in the top of the sixth. We're running on second. We're looking to gap one here. We're also looking to stay alive, you know, keep the inning going the next time. That's a close pitch. Whew. You never know, and sometimes on the show with these umpires. Going to the NL Central now. We got the Brewers here, game up on the Cubs. That should be an infield single by speed. Yeah. And homeboy's going to take third on the throw, so that's what's up. Get a base hit there. See right here, we're getting a lot of singles in this gameplay here. Sorry to my viewers that I'm not hitting bombs and shit, man. This game's a little bit of a struggle for me sometimes. I do get real fucking angry. Man, we're going to get a run out of this, so Carlos Gomez is deep enough. NL Central's pretty bad, too. I mean, the Cardinals are 5 games below 500. The Pirates are 6 games below 500. I don't know if the Brewers will sustain. I mean, the Cubs need to figure it out. Honestly, I think that they're one of the better teams in the league, but they're playing, like, straight doo-doo. And then going to the NL West, probably the best division in all of baseball. Dodgers are 1.5 up on the D-backs after they swept the Rockies, I believe. And the Rockies have fallen 4.5 back of the Dodgers. And you got the Padres here 19 back. And then you got the Giants here 23.5 back. So, I mean, definitely the Dodgers are the best team in the NL. And the Astros are for sure the best team in the AL. The only thing is, will they falter? I've seen the Astros falter before. So, what's your pick right now? Astros, Dodgers. That would be great. I think the Dodgers would take it in probably five or six games, just because of their overall talent. And you get this, and you get Kershaw twice, in the, two to three times in a 7-game series. That's honestly unfair. I mean, even though as much as I don't like Kershaw in the postseason, he's still probably the best pitcher in the league. You know, in postseason, everything's different. So, you'll see Kenley Jansen in the eighth to get a six-out save. The Dodgers have a really good bullpen, too, so it's really underrated. And top to bottom, their lineup is solid. They all great contact, especially when you got this dude Bellinger who's hitting home run after home run. You see right there. They're gonna fly out there to left fielder, line out. Here we're 2-4, the double single and an RBI. It's the top of the ninth, 7-3 score. I would not be surprised to see us lose this game, honestly. Wow, they're throwing it in there. It's like I'm being Machado to them. Machado versus the Red Sox. But yeah, I mean, overall, the Dodgers lineup top to bottom, it's great. I don't get to watch the Dodgers a lot because I live in California and I don't have Time Warner Cable or Spectrum, whatever the fuck it is now. But I watch a lot of Quick Pitch on the MLB Network. I watch a lot of MLB Network. It's just, yeah, I mean, you don't get much better than the Dodgers. That ball could have been shitted on, but it was 3-0, so we taken all the way. Finally use our showtime, and we, come on, man, that's good swing timing. That ball's got to be in the gap. Shit's ridiculous, man. There we go. 3-2 base hit. I should have got a hit in the last pitch. It was the same spot. Bullshit. But yeah. Cody Bellinger's got 23 home runs in 55 games or some shit. It's ridiculous. He's on pace for like 60 home runs probably. I have the best overall shortstop in the league. They have the best pitcher in the league. They're just deep. They can come at you all types of ways. I mean, they got guys in the rotation that'll get you six innings, and then they can turn it over to the bullpen, which is what every MLB manager wants to do. You get to your seventh, eighth, ninth guys. If your starting pitcher gives you six, that's great. So here with Todd Frazier, and he hits an absolute bomb, and that will just about do it here. Thanks for watching. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. Make sure to click that like button. We got more videos coming later this week. I'm out. Thanks, guys.